Hello, welcome back. Three more games as we make our way through the twilight years of the PlayStation 1. Only one of them this time is a survival horror. Maybe not. We'll come to that as when we play the game. So, however, first of all, let us play this one. This next game is a sequel to a game that came out the previous year. Wait, was the first game 99 or 2000? I think the first game was 2000. Maybe. Don't remember. Oh well. It's a sequel. And it has the serial number 3386. So, let me hit this. Let me hit that, and then hit this. Here we go. Tell you what, there's one thing that the my new capture card does very well, and If there's one thing my new capture card does well, it show up all of the artifacting in these old MPEG 1 videos on the PlayStation. Holy shit.
The human race, a sentient species. We dream and we ponder. This is a gift from our Maker, who uttered us into existence, but left the end of our being untold. That uncertainty torments us. And how could it be otherwise? For without knowing the end, how are we to make sense of the beginning and all those moments in between our lives?
Oh.
So we dream and we ponder in pseudo-enlightened and spiteful reflections of our Maker. We drown in desperation, hoping by chance to uncover this grand finale. Only then will we be able to weave the fragmented moments of our existence together, look back and finally comprehend the apparent maddening reason why we were born.
I'm waiting.
Well, that was an interesting intro. Fear Effect 2, Retro Helix. So, those who aren't familiar with the Fear Effect games, they are tank control, pre-rendered backgrounds, games with tank controls, and they're more action games than survival horror games. They're not really meant to be horror games. They're more like, they're like cyberpunk, you know, a little bit of Blade Runner, a little bit of Ghost in the Shell. And the first game was very good. The first game kind of suffered a little bit because of its controls. The first game, yeah. Once you get your head around the stiff controls, it's pretty damn good, but that is a significant barrier to cross. Let's have a look. What have we got? Subtitles on. I don't like the sequel as much as the first game. I don't think Fear Effect 2 is as good as the first game. Not at all. Also, I think Fear Effect 2 is a little bit gross in its in how it tends to over sexualize its main characters, and it's frankly, like, I mean, just look at the cover art below me, like, bam, center middle of the cover art, you've got two sets of cleavage immediately. It's like, okay, I get it, Eidos, I get it, your main target audience here is sexually frustrated teenage boys. I get it. I get it. I used to be one of those. I get it. But man, it... I wish it didn't have to be that way. I wish it didn't have to be that way, Eidos. Fire, quick draw, action, select weapon, inventory, forward, inventory, back, run, crouch, quick turn, evade, vibration on. So, we have the option between classic controls and 3D controls. If you're not sure what that means, classic is standard character relative movement, aka tank controls. So, pressing up on the D-pad makes your character walk forward in the direction they're already facing. Whereas 3D or camera relative controls, the direction you press on the D-pad is relative to the camera position. So pushing up, no matter what direction the character is facing, will make the character walk away from the camera towards the background, and pushing down will make the character walk towards the camera. Yes, I think that's the case. Pretty sure that's the case. Hang on. I'm pretty sure that's what that is. Let me just... Nope. Let's find out. I hope I'm right. What's this? Normal. Auto draw on. Save beacon on. Thank you. Jesus Christ, Glass. You were not that buff in the first game. Someone's been taking steroids.
According to our intelligence, the exchange will take place tomorrow. Once you obtain the intact marker and safely deliver it to us, you'll find the remainder of your fee waiting. More importantly, with the marker in our possession, my team will at last be able to fix your condition permanently. A psychotic dying of ends, a drunk and a whore. Interesting choice.
Keep this short, Hannah. This is call is on prime time, right?
I'll email you the extra dollar, Jin. I've got the case.
Where's Lung?
Swimming.
Okay. Drop it off at the usual place and I'll wire you your share. Now say thank you, Mr. G.
I'll only say that at your funeral.
Hannah, that hurts. Guess you don't want to hear about the Wing Chun gang.
What are you yakking about now?
25 mil payday, sweetheart. Maybe enough to buy back your triad contract, huh?
Keep your stinking abacus out of my life, Jin.
Then consider it investment advice. You're gonna need to bring a tech head with you on this one. I'll fill you in on the final details later.
So, was it worth dying for?
We've got an unforeseen complication, Hammer. Now listen carefully, I'm only going over this once.
Trust me, Jin. The less I talk to you, the better.
Bet you're not such a cold fish with brain. Okay, forget it. Back to business. Tonight is the annual Christmas formal at the Wing Chun campus. I thought it would be more fun if you two crashed the party. There are four sets of DNA sequences scattered in different labs on the 86th floor of the South Tower. You'll be stealing them. Check the package. You'll find two flash disks and two very expensive forged invitation bracelets that'll get you girls into the shindig. The first disk contains a genetic sequence that's missing the four sets of links that you'll be taking from Wing Chun. The other disk is a hunter program encoded to seek out the surveillance system access codes for the 80th and 86th floor. You'll need to go to the 80th floor to bypass the security system on the 86th floor. The only way to have free access on the 80th floor is to create a loop in the surveillance video at the central security hub in the basement.
Hooray, hacking minigames.
Elevator access there as well. The key card that will get Ren into Wing Chun's basement is inside the package I hid in the sculpture garden.
What's the unforeseen complication?
The only way into the garden undetected through the underground aqueduct system.
Shit! Not the aqueducts!
It bypasses all their electronic checkpoints! Find the district utility maintenance hub in the aqueducts and have Rain hack for the access codes.
That's why you told us to come in by sea. So, what else didn't you get me?
Just a hair and some fingerprints. You'll need to charm those after Dr. Liu at the party. He should be easy to spot. Just look for the richest man in the planet.
I know what he looks like, Jin. After his claims of discovering the gene that causes ends, everybody does.
Yeah, I think he's full of cow doo, but what do I know? You need his fingerprints to gain access to the high security levels via the elevator. Then use his hair and prints to issue a genetic keycard from the security analyst lab on the 86th floor.
Anything else?
There's a package for you in the east elevator shaft. Usual goodies. Hey, just enjoy the party!
So, what's the exit plan?
Exit plan? You don't get an exit plan for 15%! But how's this? Try going out the front door.
Fine. You never make things easy, do you?
Oh.
Uh-oh. Let me guess. Jin made last-minute changes to the plan, right? Yes and no. Here's the deal. Jin says...
fire in the hole. This is it. Testing. Testing. Hear me okay, Hannah?
Loud and clear.
All right. I'm going to look for the district maintenance hub and download the codes for the 80th and 86th floor. See if you can locate the exit hatch. Last one out of the aqueduct buys the champagne.
Deal. I'll even give you a head start.
Couldn't you have found, like, better-fitting wetsuits? Right. So, yeah. 3D controls. I'm pressing up on the analog stick right now. Right, down, left. So, yeah, we can now... Well, it's still a little bit stiff. It doesn't quite move smoothly. She has the largest turning circle on the planet. But I guess it's an option for people who can't stand the tank controls. Whoop. Yeah. It doesn't work too well because of the turning circle, but it's like not the worst.
What's up? You mean besides my blood pressure? We've got a blackout in the next sector, and the lock mechanism circuit is fried.
Just blast through, then.
Great idea. Was the 40 pounds of C4 packed in your backpack or mine?
Real funny, smartass. Now what?
I'll try to bypass the circuit. There's gotta be a generator somewhere. See if you can find it and bring it back online.
Done. Don't go anywhere.
Okay. So, Square and triangle to cycle through your inventory. We start this game with way more weapons than we did the first one. So we've got an Uzi, an assault rifle, a shotgun, twin pistols. Let's go twin pistols. I don't know, I'm not... kind of wishing I kept the standard tank controls now. It's just what I'm used to with these games. Like, for fuck's sake, like, couldn't you have found a wetsuit that fits? See, this is what I'm talking about, it's just... the first game didn't have this much... I mean, there was some in the first game, but it wasn't... There wasn't this much, and it wasn't so blatant. That's what annoys me. There's something down there. Okay, R1 to run. When you're close to enemies, your health bar will appear in the top left. Also, the noise they make is super obvious. Metal hook back to this room here. Whoop. Great. Security card. Okay, so we're back the way we came. First, what's over here? Oh, nothing. Okay. Save.
I don't think so.
Ugh. Just let me save. Why do I have to... Shouldn't have to cycle to the phone just to save. Okay. Moving on.
What the hell?
Darn it. These things are so ancient. I'm surprised it worked the first time. Go flip the switch again. I'll wait.
Great. Like I need the exercise.
So, they were going to make a third one of these for the PS2. There was a trailer for it and everything. Yeah, look it up. Fear Effect 3 trailer. I don't know why they cancelled it. Maybe these games weren't as successful as I thought they were. So which one? What's through this one by any... I didn't go through this door yet. Huh. Nothing. There is nothing through this door. It would be interesting to see what they would do. I mean, who has this, right? So this was an Eidos product, so that means Square Enix owns it now, because Square Enix bought Eidos. I wonder if they'll end up doing anything with it. They'll probably just make it a regular action game. Thank you. going on. No matter how many times you do it, guys, you're not going to catch me unaware. You can always tell when there's an enemy nearby because of the heart monitor in the top left. So, it kind of ruins the surprise. It's like... Oh wait, where am I going? I want to go this way. So you got to pull out the... goddamn card again. There we go.
My ears are ringing like a church bell, but I'm fine. Can't say the same for the room, though. The exit's jacked. I'm taking the section across from here. No choice.
I think you should stay put. I'll move ahead and get the codes from the district hub. Then I'll see if I can get to you somehow.
Just be careful. Who knows what else is gonna blow up.
All right, now we get to play as Rain. Rain got? Rain's got pretty much the same loadout, except instead of hand-to-hand, she's got a knife. Okay. Let's save. Okay. See the pattern. No. Oh, just run. Just run. Doesn't matter. Not an instant death anyway. That would be super annoying if that was an instant death, but luckily it's not. Shit! Fucking shoot the... Fuck. Yeah. Whatever. Let's try something heavier. Let's try the assault rifle. Fuck! No! Ugh. What? That was lucky. Ugh. You do regain health slowly over time. Ah, this is the other side of this room. Remember that dead end we found earlier? This is the other side of that flooded room. Interesting. So we know how we can get back to where we were. Try equipping that assault rifle again. Oops. again, the turning circle is a little bit too extreme for modern camera relative controls. You need to be able to turn on a dime, you know? You need to be able to just move instantly, but she doesn't. She has to rotate first. Ugh. Yep.
Not that.
Health's not coming back yet. Hopefully it will soon. Normally it comes back after a couple of minutes of quiet. This is the only way to go. Whoa! Hello. Fuck. Alright, let's try that again. Okay. But two... Alright, one more time. Quick loading, I appreciate that. If you had to wait like a good, like, 10 seconds, 10 to 15 seconds for a new load, this would get old quick. Should have moved forward more. Yeah, that still would have gotten me. Crap. No. That's enough for Fear Effect 2. Don't like it as much as the first one. I just don't. Like the first game, it comes on four discs. Not a very long game, but it has a lot of FMV, so you need a lot of storage space for all of it. Okay. Next game is another one. Another pre-rendered background tank control game. However, this one's not necessarily a survival horror. Ooh. This one, I don't know, it could be a survival action horror. It's not very scary. And also, this game is shite. It's This game is by THQ. It came out on both PlayStation 1 and Dreamcast. Neither version are particularly good. It is based on a cult film series. And as a fan of said cult film series, I expected better. But alas, alas.
Am I insane? I wouldn't necessarily say I'm crazy, simply because I've heard the voices and battled the godless things in the woods. But I must be crazy to believe. It all started with that damn book, the Necronomicon Ex Mortis. Roughly translated, the Book of the Dead. Inked in human blood and bound in flesh, the book contained bizarre burial rites, prophecies, and demon resurrection passages. Professor Raymond Nobe unearthed the book and brought it to this remote cabin where he could translate it. He awoke something dark in the woods, something evil. It got the professor. Then it came for me. It got into my hand and it went bad. So I lopped it off at the wrist. The professor's daughter, Annie, helped me fight the evil. Using the book, we opened up a vortex to send the evil back. It worked. Big time. The girl died and I got a first-class ticket to the 12th century. I led a war against an army of deadites, then used the book to get back home.
Good
back
movie.
To Dearborn. Even got my old job back. Not to mention, I met a great gal, Jenny, assistant manager, arts and crafts. We were the perfect match. But then, the nightmares came. For years, they haunted me, even when I was awake. Jenny thought I was crazy, but she agreed to help. We decided to go back to the cabin, back to where it all started.
Why would you do that?
She said it would be good to face my fears.
No!
Big mistake.
That's a very thin premise for this game. Just have the game set during Evil Dead 2. Make a video game adaptation of Evil Dead 2. You don't need to come up with this dumb, like, story about why you need to go back to the cabin again. Just make an Evil Dead 2 adaptation. That would have been way better. That's essentially what setting-wise what this game is anyway. So yeah, Evil Dead Hail to the King. This game fucking sucks.
And press the friggin' start button, would ya?
Shut the fuck up, Bruce Campbell. So as somebody who has a greater than average tolerance for tank control games, and as someone who really likes the Evil Dead franchise, this game is a bummer. Oh god. Alright.
Let's go.
New game.
At first everything looked the same. Like nothing ever happened. I wondered if all of it had just been a bad dream.
That's a real bad looking CG, Bruce Campbell.
Oh no, not again. Damn it, it won't shut off.
Sobar. Gata. Nos gata. Gata.
Jenny.
Well, back the same shit happened to the same guy. Five
this
times.
Can't be happening. Not again. Oh yeah, it's happening. It's happening in a big way. Now if you'll excuse me, duty calls.
I suppose at the time of this game's making, it would have been four times.
Workshed. Groovy.
It's a bad looking Bruce Campbell.
Jenny's out there somewhere, alive. I can feel it. If I can find the pages from the Necronomicon, I might be able to send the evil back and undo this whole mess once and for all.
So, here we go. So, this is our map. We have to explore this map and find as many pages of the Necronomicon as we can. This game has kind of an interesting structure to it, in that there's no real set path of progression. You can kind of go in any direction you want, but that's kind of where my praises for this game end. The combat sucks. It looks bad. It controls bad. Okay.
Come get some.
Oh yeah. Triangle is just taunt.
Let's go. Yo. Come get some. Let's go. Yo. Come get some.
It's it. He just has three taunts and he cycles through them all the time.
Let's go. Yo.
So, square button to use the axe, or right-hand weapon, or sorry, left-hand weapon, and X to use the chainsaw, or right-hand weapon. Circle, I believe, is examine, so... Tank controls, just like Resident Evil. This game is not scary at all, not even in the slightest. R1 to run, and the running animation is the goofiest fucking running animation ever. He just kind of lopes across the room. Oh, fuck's sake. The combat's terrible. Wander up to a guy and just keep hitting him. And then they run away.
Come get some.
Small health kit. So yeah, they've done a half decent job of recreating the cabin from Evil Dead. Even down to the trap door. You just gotta kinda just... You know what? I'm just gonna turn the game volume down. It gets kinda loud during combat. Basically, you just kinda just alternate attacks. Oh, there we go. Luckily, this game is not stingy with health items, so...
Let's go.
It's almost impossible to get through combat without taking some damage. It's just the nature of it is just clunky and clumsy.
Hey, there's a page right there.
Okay, found our first page.
Yo.
Wait, how do we...
Come get some.
Your best friend and social interface with the undead. I like that. That's funny. Double-bladed axe.
Groovy. 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 Groovy.
Hmm. That's the kitchen. That's a really shitty looking bathroom.
Let's go.
Anything in the kitchen I can use without the fridge? Hey, there's a sandwich. But how much health? I don't know. Should I use it now or should I use it later? How do I use that? Should we go out the front door? Let's go out the front door. Or should we go out the back door?
Yo.
Alright. Motherfucker. Where? Where are you? You gonna appear behind me or in front of me? Combat is terrible. It's just shit. And then they run away from you, which is a pain. The controls suck. Alright, you can tell when they're dead. Oh, for a second I thought he died there, but I guess not. Fuck. Is that it? Is that all of him? Tedious. Hang on, let me turn the game down a bit more. It's still very loud. For me, at least. What is this? Harvested for fuel. There we go. Let's go around the side.
Ah!
come get some.
Come on. Ugh. They appear to be just invincible for the first couple of seconds after they leave the ground, because I hit them and nothing happens. Crowbar used to pry things open. No shit. I need to combine it with something. This is filled with a large amount of fuel for your chainsaw. Yeah, how the hell do you suppose... Is there a way to actually make the chainsaw, like... R2 to rev the chainsaw. Okay. So I suppose the chainsaw would do more damage if it was on. Small amount of fuel. Nice! I'm pressing R2, nothing is happening. R2 is doing nothing. Another mushroom. So yeah, hang on. L1 is sidestep, so that's like a dodge maneuver. Fuck, yeah, another one. Do these guys just respawn? I hope not, that would be super lame if they just respawn forever. Tedious. This is so tedious. How the fuck do I use the chainsaw? Okay, yeah. R2 to start rev chainsaw. Okay. Oh, it worked. Why is it working now? Why didn't it work before? Yeah, that does way more damage. That died a lot faster with a revved chainsaw. Okay, L2 to turn off the chainsaw. Oh, 45 caliber bullets. Oh, is this a storage chest? Like Resident Evil. This is what this is, isn't it? Yeah, see a thing on the top here, you can store things. Okay, so let's For now, let's store these guys. If your scientific experiments with a converter. What? Let's go exploring. These guys do respawn. Christ. Died quickly, but that still wasn't much fun.
Let's go.
Oh, fucking hedge maze. Are you serious? Hello. Yeah, the enemies do respawn. Motherfucker. Asshole. Oh, fuck you! Hang on. This combat is the worst. I remember seeing a review for this in a Dreamcast magazine, like when I was younger. I think that's how I was familiar with it. I didn't have it or play it at the time because the magazine at the time said it was shit, and I can see how they might have thought that. What's this? Brown mushroom. Nutrients can be extracted from these fungi. Nope. Well. I needed some weed killer, eh? The respawning enemies are a huge bummer. Oh, you motherfucker, and you're blocking the path as well, you cunt. So you have to fight them in this awful... Get out of my way. For your sake, you better drop some goddamn health. Oh, good. Let's go this way. Another fucking mushroom.
Come get some.
Respawning enemies is never a good idea. Oh, that's just a dead end. Great. Perfect. Oh, fuck me. Never thought that fighting dancing skeletons with a chainsaw and a hedge maze would be so just aggravating and boring. There was another Evil Dead game similar to this for the PS2. There was another one, I think. I'm not sure if that was any good either. I want to say that might have been a bad game as well. I'm running out of fuel. Nope, no health. There's a guy up here who's gonna respawn. Yep, there he is. Let's go this way. Just aggravating. Just come back. Just come back. Nope, no health. Fine, be that way. What's this? Oh, it's another dead end. Hooray. Joy. Oh, fuck you! Like, have them respawn, like, after, like, a few minutes, not just immediately. Oh, fuck's sake. This is the most aggravating thing. As well. Ooh, another one. You dropped two. Thank you. That was bizarre. Come on, you fuck. Yes. You look like one of those skeletons from like the 19, like a 1930s Warner Brothers cartoon. You know, one of those dancing skeletons. Okay, okay. Where? Okay. And my chainsaw's almost out of fuel again. Ah, perfect timing. Another house by the looks of it. What the fuck is that? Fuck you! Oh, no sound effect. I like that there was... Okay. That was actually kind of funny. Alright, the animation on that, like, zombie thing... was actually kind of ridiculous. Kind of similar to how some of the monsters in the Evil Dead 2 and Army of Darkness behaved. Just no subtlety. Just blah. Just like floating ragdolls. Great. That was actually kind of great. Moonshine jug. Homemade moonshine. Don't get any on your hands. I'll try not to.
Groovy.
Let's try out this gun. Okay. The gun's probably shit too. Oh, you mean like a lever? Should I find a lever? Is that what you mean? Another mushroom. Who cares about mushrooms? Actually, where in the world am I? On there, okay. Oh, great. Clashing audio samples.
Oh, it's locked.
Can't go that way.
Ah, nice place for an undead redneck.
We can't get in because it's locked. What are you? A crank! Okay, there we go. Ugh. Turn the volume up just a little bit. It seems the game's very quiet. Most of the time, but it gets very loud during combat, so... Mm. A Okay, yes.
Yo.
Yes. Yes, I know. I've got one here. Can I use this? Is this a thing I can use? No. Yes, I know. I've got the crank. Maybe this is the wrong crank. Maybe this is not what it's meant for. Circle, square, no.
Let's go.
Try hitting inventory button while in this view. No, oh, shit. No. Nope, that didn't appear to work. Maybe it's the wrong one. Maybe we need a different crank to start that motor. Well, that was disappointing. Oh, fuck. Appears to be not effective. Just because he's a ghost man, or... What the? That was ridiculous. Back at the among other things, among decapitating your ex-girlfriend. Fuck! Speaking of which, hello! Watch Evil Dead 2. Oh, she just disappeared. She just disappeared. Oh, fuck's sake. I'm out of here. I don't care anymore. They give you all these items, but there doesn't appear to be much use for them. I'm assuming here is a good spot to use a shovel. But nope. Thank you. Fuck this. Seriously, fuck this. This is lame. This is dumb. I'm running. Leave me alone. Okay, yep, there's the curled bridge. Good. They drop a lot of health. That's nice of them. Just run. Just run. Who gives a shit? Just run. Oh, look, there's another one. Fuck it. Go. Oh, what's this? Jesus Christ. Christ, you put the... You got your foot on the accelerator hard enough, buddy. Jesus. Oh, zombie children.
Come get some.
Oh, fuck it, let's just make a space. Who cares? Smelt jerky. Okay, it's a health item. Alright. Don't even know what it is. No, don't care.
Yo.
Just run. I don't care. This is lame. Another fucking mushroom. Oh, no. Fuck this hedge maze. Just let him kill me.
Oh!
It's the kind thing to do. Yeah, this game sucks. It's the combat more than anything. If the combat wasn't so annoying, then it might be more enjoyable. But it's so clunky and so clumsy, and it's just... No. Not good. Evil Dead, Hail to the King. Watch the films, don't play the games. Alright. Continuing on the horror theme, although this next game is not a horror game. This is an adventure game. This is an adventure game from French company Wanadu and Cryo. Same people... This game uses the same tech as the... What was it? Amazon, The Explorer's Legacy. Do you remember that first-person adventure game I showed you several videos ago? So yeah, this is a game that uses the same technology as that game. One of a dozen games put out by this same company, Wanadu, that use that same tech. These guys seem to put out like two or three games like that a year. Like, there's Dracula games, there's Necronomicon. There's a game that takes place in a museum. You play like a Lara Croft style character sneaking into a museum. I think it's called the Louvre or something. You've got Amazon, which is actually half decent. And then there's like two or three Atlantis themed games. And they've all used the exact same technology, and most of them are not very good. This game uses the mouse. Okay, and let's start a new game. I didn't click it for fun. Let's... I'm going to go close that window before any more assholes decide to use the road outside my house as a drag strip. Okay. So... We start off in this house, and there's a knock at the door, so we've got to go answer it. So yeah, this game uses pretty much the same technology as every single other wannadoo adventure game. It's just the same engine that Amazon ran on. And since this is the PlayStation 1 version, everything is super low res.
Edgar?
William. William.
What's going on?
Listen to look at me. You'd think I'm not right in the head. But the reasons for my condition are far more awful than mere madness. William. What I've discovered goes beyond understanding. You just have to believe me. We're all in the gravest danger. That's why I keep on looking, but the more I learn, the more this thing devours me. I've been sentenced to death, William. For our friendship's sake, I ask you to look after this. Don't speak of it to anyone, don't give it to anyone, not even to me. Especially if I ask for it.
Okay, what was that last shot there of that random field? Wrong mouse. So, click the right mouse button to access our inventory. We have this weird little pyramid. Documents. We have no stored documents, so. Oh, someone else at the door.
Mr. William Stanton, I presume. Allow me to introduce myself. Dr. Robert Eagleton, physician and friend of Sir Christopher Wycherley. I would like to talk to you about his son, Edgar Wycherley, who, if I'm not mistaken, is a friend of yours. I know Edgar too well not to notice the signs of insane delirium.
Either he's really tall or we're really short.
The terror he's experiencing cannot be easily dismissed. Are you aware of the rumors circulating about Dr. Owens in Port Tuxedt Village? I fear greatly for your friend. So do his parents, and some of my psychiatric colleagues are talking of internment. You see, I would greatly value your considered opinion. Please, would you pay him a visit?
Yes, of course I will.
Thank you, William.
Facial animation.
Contact me as soon as you run into him again. Goodbye, young fellow. Thank you again for your help.
What did he give me? Some kind of paper, a business card or something? What is this? Robert Eagleton. Mouse sensitivity is very low. And there is no real way to increase it. I have to kind of just drag the mouse just to get it to move around. Can't click on the clock. Can I go upstairs? No, I can't go upstairs. I can go back in here. I have many leather-bound books. And my apartment smells of rich mahogany. Don't worry if you don't get that reference. It's okay. Hmm. guess I can't. I just can't grab it. I need. I can't. Nope. There's nothing in this drawer, and I need something to open. That's what the two cogs mean. I need an item to open that little drawer there. So. Okay. Maybe we have the key hidden somewhere here. Aha! That looks like a key to me. The newspaper? No. Okay, fine. Right, so right click. God, the load times are pretty serious. Grab the key. Use key on drawer. Grab key, grab coins. Now we've got our key. This is. Where are we? I guess we must be in. Considering this is a H.P. Lovecraft style story, we must be on the. Somewhere in the East Coast, somewhere. East Coast of America, that is. So we can't walk down the street, since there's no little logo. Ooh, mailbox. Ooh, what are you? The Providence Gazette. Today, Black Tuesday for dock users. Our reporter, Jack Johnston, took workers in the air in order to gather more precise information on the threatened strikes in response to the string of incidents in recent months. For a new newspaper, the ink on this thing is shitty and faded. Like, for fuck's sake, fix your printer. I don't know, maybe it was delivered in the rain. Maybe it got wet before it was delivered. I don't know. Commercial activity from this morning. Details on page 2. Oh well. Not going to keep that. How do I get out? There we go. Got to close it first. I need. Aha! Let's grab our key that we got earlier. No helmet. Man, living life on the edge. Do we want to go left or do we want to go right? Let's go left. To this house. Who's... Okay, the perspective on this is ridiculous. So if I look at the door like this, it looks like a normal sized door, but if I look up, holy shit, I'm... That's either a massive door or I'm 4 feet tall. Yeah. Can I knock on the door? No? Not at all. No, I guess not. Okay. I guess we should have gone right. At this incredibly depressing looking town. What is this? Nope. Across the street. Knock on every door.
Hello? Anyone there?
Be on your way, stranger.
Alright, fine. Be that way, you miserable bastard. Jesus! Hello.
Excuse me.
What is it?
Do you know where Mr. Witcherly lives?
Witcherly?
Well, you are a lot of help. Thanks.
Good day, sir. Do you, by chance, know where Edgar Witcherly lives, please?
Edgar Witcherly? Who might that be?
Wow. This town. Try over here. I'm sure this must be thrilling. Can't click on that house, okay. What's this? Some kind of pier. No such luck. Nope. There's somebody down here. We can ask this fine gentleman.
Excuse me, sir. Do you know...
Wow. People in this town suck. Around. Let's ask this old man sitting down if he can't run away.
Excuse me. Could you tell me where Edgar Wycherley lives?
Wycherley, eh? No. Don't know him.
Can I try the church, maybe? What about this white house over here that stands out from the literally every other building on the street? Crum and Son. Oh, it's closed. Crap. Oh well. That was a nice thought. Ooh.
Please, sir, do you... That's not very polite.
God damn it, man. Have a backbone. Get angry. Don't just... Can we get in the church, maybe? No? Can't click on the church. Can't even... No, that just takes us down the side of the church. Okay, fine. Jesus. This is dire. This is... This is miserable.
Leave us alone!
What's down this alleyway? Not much. Oh, hello.
Whatever the young man's looking for, he should ask Ma Brady.
I'm looking for Edgar Wycherley's residence. Do you know it?
For a few coins, kind soul.
Okay. Lucky we picked up those coins, eh? Because if we hadn't picked them up, we'd have to go all the way back to our house, go back into that drawer, grab the coins and come back. And at that point, I would have stopped playing. Alright, coins. Bribe the old peasant lady.
Go see Mr. Crumb at the grocery store. You can't miss it.
You mean the one that's closed? We've already been there. It's closed. Or I guess it's magically open now because the game says it is. That was busy work. That was a pointless puzzle. Alright. Who wants to bet this store is now just going to be magically open? Yep, look, the close sign has disappeared. That's lame.
Crumb and Son. At your service.
Don't slouch, buddy. I'm a customer. Look like you're glad to have me here. Is that a matchbook? I've still got some coins left, it seems.
I'm looking for Edgar Wycherley's house. Do you know it?
Mr. Wycherley, you say? No. I'd have to... Will you be needing anything else, sir?
Alright. God, you have to fucking bribe everyone in this town.
An excellent choice. That's a dollar, sir.
Alright, back into the inventory, grab some cash.
Thank you. Edgar Wycherley, for the love of God. I'm only a simple grocer, sir, trying to make a living. What you need, sir, is a map. Then I can show it to you. This one costs $20, sir.
For a fucking map? Okay, if this is set in, like, turn of the century, like, late 19th, early 20th century, you know, in which most of which H.P. Lovecraft's stories are set, $20 is a lot of fucking money. It's like, what? That's insane. Okay. So that was a match box I bought. Okay.
Here you are, sir. I've marked the address you wanted with a cross. That's $40 altogether.
Fuck you!
Thank you, and look after yourself, sir.
Fucking con artist. Again, I'm assuming the script wasn't particularly great in this game because it was made by French people who probably don't know a huge amount of the country they're basing the game in and maybe didn't bother to do as much research as maybe they should have. Here we go, map. So I'm going to go here, maybe. Huh. What a cheerful place. Hello?
Yes? Mr. Witcherly has gone out. Don't push it, he's out. The gentleman can't have heard. Perhaps young sir would like his ears unblocked for him. No, then scram.
Is it death?
Listen, my son. If you bother me again, I'll beat you to a pulp. Got it? Right, that's it. You're dead meat.
Fuck. Okay, that's pretty funny. I like that. You harass this guy enough and he'll just beat the shit out of you. I think that's probably enough. See, yeah. None of the games shown in this video were particularly great. I mean, Evil Dead was genuinely a bummer. I don't know. Fear Effect 2 seems to be well made. And if you really, really like the original Fear Effect game, it's got that going for it. Necronomicon seems more hilarious than scary. I don't know. Some low budget French adventure games for you. Ugh. Anyway, I think that's it. That's enough from me. I shall see you next time with three more games as we work our way down. We're about halfway now down this final stack of PlayStation 1 games. We've got another two, maybe three videos out of what's left. Alright. I shall see you next time. Goodbye.